This episode is brought to you by Squarespace. A curious group of explorers stumble upon a planet. Their sensors pick up an interesting chemical profile, large amounts of water, temperatures moderate enough to keep most of it liquid, an atmosphere containing higher than expected levels of oxygen. The land is oddly green. It's an abnormal place, worth investigating. This planet's name is Earth. These explorers will find an Earth teeming with life, but in our story, Homo sapiens is not among them. Maybe we've moved on, maybe we've died out, but this planet is no longer ours. The strange plants and animals, although our explorers wouldn't call them that, can only tell how this planet is, not how it was. But they have knowledge of geology, they understand the strata of rocky planets, and where they examine layers of rock, stacked one on top of another, they'll be able to piece together our story. Consider what we know about the dinosaurs. They existed for more than 100 million years, yet we've only uncovered a few thousand complete remains. Our species has been around for just a fraction of that time, but despite this relatively short existence, we've left a huge mark. And today, scientists are more certain than ever we've changed the Earth to such an extent that geologists digging in the distant future would classify this as a totally new epoch, the Anthropocene. But when would it begin, and what would they find there? The rise of farming, countless empires, most of human history's time span, in fact, would be almost invisible in the rock. But they'd notice us. During the Industrial Revolution, our species numbered a billion for the first time, accelerating until around 1950, when population growth and human consumption explode. The Great Acceleration. This era of unprecedented economic change and consumption would be unmistakable in the rocks. Our waste contains materials never before seen on Earth. I want to say one word to you, just one word: plastics. Every year, we pump out a mass of plastic equal to the weight of all humans on Earth. And not just plastics, also glass and bricks. Although they're made from raw materials, they're modified by heat into forms that are both long-lasting and notably organized. Consider aluminum. It was essentially unknown in its pure elemental form before the 19th century. Yet since 1950, we've produced enough for every human alive to make a stack of cans half a kilometer high. Enough concrete has been produced to pave all of Earth, and half of that since just 1995. All of this stuff would mark the most new minerals created since oxygen first built up in our atmosphere, 2.4 billion years before you're watching this video. And beyond these raw materials would be traces of the things that we've made with them, our technofossils, from planes and phones to paper clips and lost ballpoint pens. Countless confusing traces of our time. And should those future explorers be versed in chemistry, they'd find metals and rare earth elements spread worldwide, and strangely missing from the lower layers where we dug them up. A few, like platinum, rhodium, and palladium, would be strangely concentrated along strands of a strange web, ejected from the tailpipes of our cars on our roads. They'd see huge spikes of nitrogen and phosphorus from fertilizer production. And were they to find ice on this future Earth, ice cores would show sudden spikes in methane and carbon dioxide, like nothing seen in the 800,000 years previous. If they found fossils, they would see many species go from local concentrations in older layers to a sudden global spread. These are marks of our domestic animals and plants and invasive species. Like we've witnessed in our own time, these future explorers would see a spike in the number of species that suddenly disappear from the fossil record, a mass extinction event. And we've talked about this at length in a previous video, and we just don't know how bad it will get. But as they decoded the dawn of the Anthropocene, there would be one mark clearer than all the others, tracing back to a single day in Earth's history. July 16th, 1945, the detonation of the first atomic bomb, rare radioactive elements like plutonium-239 and all of its decay products would leave a chemical signature that our future explorers could not help but notice, although they might not be able to explain its origins. It makes you wonder, what would they think of us? What picture of our species, of our culture, would they connect from all of these dots? Whoever it may be that one day examines the Anthropocene, the layer of Earth that will represent us, remember that we control what it holds and how much time it will represent. Stay curious. In case all you future explorers are wondering, this episode of It's Okay to Be Smart was made possible by Squarespace. Squarespace is an easy way to create a website, blog, or online store for you and your ideas. Squarespace features a user-friendly interface, custom templates, and 24/7 customer support. You can try Squarespace at squarespace.com/itsokaytobesmart for a special offer. Squarespace. Build it beautiful. The word season was born on the farm, since for a long time, surviving another trip around the sun meant knowing when to sow your seeds. In most our minds, winter is when it's coldest, summer is when it's hottest, and spring and autumn happen in between. You probably figured that much out before kindergarten, but those aren't the seasons on your calendar. In most of the Northern Hemisphere, especially in the US, the coldest quarter of the year begins several weeks before the official start of winter.